So I'm going to try and address an often asked question about fasting, especially about breaking the fast. Again, this is probably the 52nd hour of fasting for me. And people always ask, how do you deal with hunger? Or after you break the fast, do you eat normally? Or do you eat for full hunger? That was a question asked. It made me laugh out loud, because these kind of questions come from a place of deep misunderstanding. This question assumes that I am hungry. I am not hungry at all. I'm totally peaceful. I have no hunger. That's because I am metabolically flexible. I've trained myself to be metabolically flexible. So unless you get your head around this concept, this idea, you will have all irrelevant questions. All the questions will be irrelevant to your journey. Okay? So how hungry will you be? How will you break your fast? How much will you eat? And all these questions come from a place of lack of empathy for the other. You think that what you are going through, what you as a person are going through, is the same thing I am going through as well, which is not true. I am going through a different experience. And once you understand that, these questions will not come into play. I am not upset that you have asked this question, but I started thinking, why are people asking these questions? It is because you don't understand that I am not uncomfortable. You don't understand that I am not uncomfortable because you cannot be comfortable right now, is all I'm saying. You can train yourself. Just because you cannot be comfortable, you think that the other is not comfortable as well. So there is no problem, you know, I will go and eat only because I want to break my fast. I have no compulsion to eat now. Okay? Think about this. See, I am 80 kilograms, right? Maybe 20% body fat. Okay? So 16 kilograms of fat I have on me. 16 kilograms of fat. Let's be very generous and say that 10 kilograms of those fat are essential. They are not essential, but let's just be nice to Ramachandran. Okay, I have 6 kilograms of extra fat. So each kilogram is 1000 grams. Okay, so 6000 grams of extra fat. Each gram has about 10 calories. Okay, 9 calories, but for Ramachandran is not very good at mathematics. So we'll keep it as 10 calories, okay? So 6,000 into 10 is how much? 60,000, right? I have 60,000 calories in my body, excess. And we are not even taking that other 10 kilograms, okay? That is 1 lakh more calories. Actually, I have 1,60,000 calories. I have a Saravana Bhavan I have a hotel in my body, okay? Now, the question you have to ask is, how come an organism that is carrying so much energy still seeks energy from the outside? Why does it not use the energy from within? And the reason is that organism does not know how to use it. Do you understand what I mean? So let's say that I'm carrying, it's like you carry a tiffin box full of food and yet you are looking for a hotel to feed your hunger. It makes no sense because you don't know how to open your tiffin box, or you don't know how to open your box that contains the food. Once you train yourself to open that box, and the way to train yourself, go look at Dr. Jason Fung. Just look at metabolic flexibility on YouTube. Just type in the search metabolic flexibility. Okay? The basic thing is, if you quit sugar itself, 80% of the problem is solved right there. So the point I'm trying to make is, in these long fasts, this is not even long, 2 days is not long, okay, but there is no hunger, there is no discomfort, okay, so unless you experience it, you will keep asking these kind of questions that are totally useless to your journey. The best thing for you to do is to get on the journey and see for yourself. And if you are hungry, you can always break the fast, right? It's not a crime to break your fast. So how do you assume that you are going to be hungry even before you start? Don't do that. First get on the journey, experience the journey, and then you can ask intelligent questions. Okay? Thank you.